.NET 8 introduces a new way to access private members with zero performance overhead through the use of the Unsafe Accessor attribute. This works by defining an extern static method which matches the signature of the member you want to access and decorating the method with an Unsafe Accessor attribute in order to provide some additional required information. Let's take a look at an example. Let's consider the following class. It's got a private method called test, which we want to invoke. To do that, we start by defining our own extern static method. The method signature must match the signature of the method we're targeting, so the return type must be string. For the name of the method, we can use anything we want, so we'll go with invoke test method. Now, for the list of parameters, the first parameter is going to be an object instance of the target type, similar to when you call invoke using reflection. The rest of the parameters must match the list of parameters in the target method. In our case, there's a single parameter, int value. We're almost there, but there's still some information missing. We don't know yet the name of the member or its kind, whether it's a method or property or field and so on. We specify this information using the new Unsafe Accessor attribute. In our example, the kind will be Unsafe Accessor kind.method. And for the name, we're going to say test. That's it. Now we can go ahead and invoke the private method. First thing we need is an object instance on which to invoke the method, so we're quickly going to create one. Then we're going to simply call invoke test method, passing our object instance foo and the test integer value, say 36. To actually see that it runs, we're going to grab the return value into a variable and print it out using console_write_line. And now, if we run the code, we should see instance method 36 printed on the screen. And indeed we do. Now, there are a few variations to this setup depending on the kind of member you are trying to access. For example, if you wanted to access a property, you'll notice that there's no unsafe accessor kind.property. That's because property are accessed through their getter and setter methods. For getting the property value, our method will be called get underscore, followed by the property name, and will have a matching return type. We follow a similar convention for setting the property. The name of the method will be set underscore, followed by the name of the property, and the value to be set will be passed in as a parameter. Next, let's have a look at private constructors. The main difference in this case is that you don't need to provide an object instance as a parameter. Instead, the return type of the method will match the target type. Fields are accessed by reference through a slightly different construct using the ref keyword. Our method signature changes to extern static ref, followed by the field type, and passing an object instance as a parameter. For the member name, we use the actual name of the private field. Once everything is set up, you read the value by invoking the method, and you set it by doing instance field of object instance equals the new value. One thing to note here is that just like in the case of reflection, this works with read-only fields as well. Static methods, properties, and fields are accessed in the same way as their instance counterparts. The only difference being which unsafe accessor kind we need to specify, static method and static field. You even need to provide an object instance for accessing them, which begs the question, what about static classes? As it turns out, static classes are not currently supported by unsafe accessors. There's an API proposal open on GitHub which aims to bridge this gap, but it's only targeting .NET 9. I'll leave a link to it in the video's description. And I believe that pretty much covers unsafe accessors. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit the like button and subscribe for more videos to come.